Good evening. Welcome to Community Yoga at Hazel Jane by Barefoot Freedom Yoga. My name is Erin. I guess we're in for another month of this fun, and that's all right, I guess. We're doing it all to keep the people we love safe and to make sure that there's enough healthcare for everybody to go around. So I'm working hard to try to find peace with this strange new normal. You're probably in the same boat as me, unless you're an essential worker. And if you are, God bless you for going out there and taking care of people. I thought that the theme for this evening might be nice to explore sinking into stillness. I'm having a little bit of stir craziness as I want to get outside, I want to do things, and I keep having to stop myself and remind myself that there's a reason I'm staying here inside. I can't just go out and grab everything that I want when I want it. And I thought that was a nice resonator with the things that I struggle with when I practice yoga, when I sit and meditate, all those things that that help us to practice stillness, because stillness is a skill that you have to cultivate. So we'll work a little bit on that this evening. I bet nobody else, unless you're very lucky like me, gets to practice in a bacon-scented studio right now, so you might be jealous. It's going to be a little distracting for me. You can start to find your way down onto your mat. We're going to start in Shavasana, corpse pose. And you can do this with a traditional Shavasana, where you lay on your back and extend your legs long. You can let your toes wave a little bit and then settle out towards the corner of the mat. You can lay on a blanket or a pillow. You can even do this in a chair. Just sit nice and comfortably in a way where you can let all of your muscles relax. Feel your bones become heavy. Feel your weight settling down, sinking into stillness. Bring your attention to your body, checking in with any places where you might be holding on to some tension from the day. Just notice those places that are tight at first. You don't have to do anything about it. Just notice and see what happens. And take a few minutes while we relax here to focus on your breath. Simply breathe deeply. As you relax, maybe you feel the breath filling up your belly, feeling that soften, feeling the belly expand in all four directions. Maybe you feel the ribs moving, the lower ribs flaring out, the upper chest rising. Take another breath or two, just enjoying the stillness and this opportunity to focus for a moment and be present in your body. As we continue our practice, see if you can take along some of this heaviness and relaxation. And when we start to move, let's move very intentionally. We don't need to waste any energy. or movement. When you're ready, you can pull in your legs and start to roll yourself over onto your right side. If you're in a chair, just stay where you are. Maybe bring some movement to your fingers and toes, rolling the wrists and ankles, just becoming aware of how the body feels this evening. And gently start to press yourself up to a seated position. Again, if you're in a chair, you don't need to do anything extra. Maybe just sit a little taller. Maybe rock a little bit side to side, feeling the sits bones either on the floor, on the chair, wherever you are, they are your foundation. You can rock front to back, side to side. And then come back to stillness, imagining the curves of the spine, imagining the vertebrae stacking one on the other, all the way up the back. Feel the neck is long. You can pretend there's a string attached to the crown of your head and it's pulling up so that you can sit tall with no effort. And with every exhale, see if you can relax a little bit of tension wherever you're holding it in your body. Maybe it's shoulders, maybe it's belly or lower body. Maybe it's the face, the jaw, the eyes, the mouth. Just take a moment, breathing in, sit tall. Breathing out, relax the shoulders. There's nowhere to be other than where you are right now. And there's nothing that needs your attention more than your breath and each sensation you feel in your body as we practice. Let's bring some gentle movement into our practice. With each inhale, we can raise our arms out, stretching wide, tracing a wide circle all the way up, reaching high. Exhale, let those arms float back down, tracing a nice wide circle. Move slowly, noticing sensations in the muscles and joints. Inhale up overhead. Exhale, trace the circle wide all the way back down. Take another at your own pace. Just focus on your own breath. Inhale up. Exhale out and down. Maybe take another. Good, coming back to seated. Let's press our hands together at heart center. And spread your fingers nice and wide, all the way apart from each other, pressing the palms together, elbows out. And let's see if we can point our middle fingers forward and down. Inhale, bring them back up, maybe all the way in towards the chest. Just playing with the range of motion with the wrists and the elbows and the shoulders. Notice where you feel this. Maybe this is easy, maybe this is harder than you expected. Just notice all the sensations. Good, let's relax the arms down. On your next inhale, let's spread the arms wide up at shoulder height, reaching through the fingertips as far as you can. You can look towards each hand, loosening up the neck and shoulders. And take some very small circles with the arms, tracing circles with the fingertips. Start small, maybe get a little bigger. You can play around fast or slow, whatever feels good, just noticing the sensations in the body. Little circles do a lot. They bring up the synovial joint fluid that helps keep our joints moving and lubricated. Come to stillness, noticing for a moment what that feels like. And then make some little circles in the other direction. Hopefully you can remember and tell the difference. Play around, big circles, small circles, fast or slow. And on your next inhale, reach up. Exhale, all the way down. Take a moment sitting tall, feeling those sits bones on the ground again. You can clasp onto your knees or hold onto your ankles. And do a little bit of cat-cow motion, like rounding the back, looking down. Looking up, bringing the heart up. Exhale, send the heart back. Inhale, heart forward. Take a couple more, exploring the sensations, and then come back to stillness when you're ready. Good, shake it off, sit nice and tall, sinking into this stillness, feeling the foundation of the sits bones. One more warm up here. If you're on the ground, you can place a hand over to the side. If you're in a chair, you can just place a hand on a leg or off the side of the chair. We're gonna do a side bend, bringing one arm up and over. Inhale. Exhale, coming back to center. Sitting tall. Inhale, go the other way. Feeling the side bend, noticing the sensations in the body. Inhale, up and over. Exhale, back to center. Good, get a little flow going. Feel all the muscles working together to make your motions nice and smooth and graceful and intentional. And we'll come back to seated, enjoying the stillness. Noticing the way our body feels now towards the beginning of practice. We'll keep checking in, making sure we bring our focus back to the present moment, back to the breath, back to the body, back to where we are. Stay seated. I'm going to turn to the side. We can bring our feet out in front of us. If you are in a chair, you can just watch. There won't be, if you're in a chair, I appreciate you joining for the warm-ups. We're gonna continue on the floor, so feel free to join us on the floor if you feel safe with that. So I'm sitting back, maybe rocking a little bit on the sits bones, feeling your balance, maybe rounding the back, just like we did before with the cat-cow motions, feeling how that is when your weight comes on your tailbone. And we'll come into boat pose. And you can do this slowly. You can place your hands back for support, maybe just raising one leg at a time, getting used to the abs engaging to hold up as a strong core. You can continue with this flow. You can bring both legs up so that they're parallel with the ground. You can still use your hands for support, or you can play with bringing one hand, two hands, one hand at a time up forward. Sit up nice and tall, reaching through the crown of the head. The spine is long. For a final variation, you can stay here or you can straighten the legs. Feel the strength in the body. Reach up through the crown of the head. Sink down just an inch or two as if you're going to come onto your back. And then let's come back up to boat. One more time, sink back. Back up to boat, one more time. Rolling and then coming back up. Good job. This time we'll actually roll down. You can do it straight from boat pose. Or you can place the hands or the feet down. Just start to roll down one vertebrae at a time with control. Coming onto your back once more, Shavasana. Take a nice couple of breaths here, enjoying that stillness after effort. Breathe deeply, soften the belly. Sink a little bit further into the ground. Let's bring one leg up into the chest. Give a little squeeze. Maybe rock a little side to side. Let's bring the other knee into the chest. Both knees hugging in. You can rock side to side or draw little circles with the knees if you like a sacral massage. You might feel some pops and cracks as things get warmed up. Totally normal. Just move slowly and listen to your body. Hug both knees into the chest and raise the forehead up towards the knees. Breathing here. Feeling the weight of the body press on the muscles around the spine. We're going to roll ourselves up. You can take a couple of rocking chair rolls. If you can get up all the way, you can go ahead and roll all the way to tabletop. Or if that's too hard, you can always roll onto your side and press yourself up. So I'm coming all the way forward over my crossed legs, coming into tabletop. Good job. Spreading my hands nice and wide, pressing into the fingertips. Let's bring our weight onto our left foot and press back through the right foot, nice and strong, imagining reaching through the crown of the head and out through that foot. Squeezing the elbows in at our sides, press the heart down a little bit and press back up in a little bow. Still keeping that nice straight line. Just continuing to wake up all the muscles in the body, getting a little bit of upper body crunch there. Bring that leg down. You can take some hip circles. Letting the weight of the legs and the hips fall back and loosen up the hip joints and the lower back. And now we'll do the other side, pressing into the fingertips and the knuckles, bringing our weight to our right leg. We'll press out through the left leg, nice and straight and level. And then we'll squeeze our elbows in at our sides and bring our heart a little closer to the mat. Maybe it's a little, maybe it's a lot. We'll press ourselves back up. You can take a couple of those, maybe three or five, depending on where you're at. Good. Let's float that foot back down. And let's sink back to child's pose for a moment. Knees wide, toes together, hips sinking back. See if you can sink a little bit into the mat here. Let the belly fall through the legs. Let the hips sink back. Sinking into a deep stillness here. Feel the breath in the back body. See if you can fill your whole back with air like a balloon. When you're ready, on an inhale, float back up to tabletop. Knees under hips, shoulders under, or wrists under shoulders, and we're gonna tuck our toes under. Maybe place our weight back, warming up those toes, letting them settle on the mat, feeling the balls of the feet on the mat. We're gonna round our back like we do for cat pose, like an angry cat. Press into the feet and hover the knees just a little bit off the ground. Feel the abs engage like they did for boat pose. We're gonna hold here, find stillness, even if it's uncomfortable. Let's start to press the hips up and back into a downward dog. Take it slow on this first one. You can leave the knees nice and bent. You can work one knee at a time, walk the dog, setting one heel down at a time. Notice the sensations in the body where you might be tight. Maybe it's a surprise, maybe it's not.
see if you can keep a nice straight line pressing the hips up and back. You can always drop down into child's pose again or down to tabletop, whatever you need to do, especially if you feel like your wrists need a break. Let's walk the hands back towards the feet, coming into a forward fold again. Keep those knees soft. They might be bent, and that's okay. Hamstrings aren't always meant to have a super intense stretch. I'm taking off my coat if I can. I'm super awkward today. Just relax in a forward fold for a moment. You can shake your head yes and no. You can shake the upper body. Just see if you can hang in stillness. Let's start to walk our hands back out to downward dog, pressing into the fingers, pressing into the knuckles. Bring the shoulders away from the ears. You can still walk the dog if you need to. Optional strengthener. Inhale and flow forward into plank. Exhale back to downward dog. You can do that a couple of times if that's in your practice and you're trying to get stronger. Everybody kneading back and downward dog, let's start to walk our feet heel toe, nice and slow toward the top of the mat, coming into a fold. Again, those knees might be bent. That's okay. Just notice where you feel tense. See if you can hang in stillness. Just let the upper body be loose. And let's roll up like a rag doll, nice and slow. Let the arms and the head hang heavy as you roll up one vertebra at a time. Stacking like blocks, coming into alignment. Shoulders coming into alignment over hips. Head floating up. Imagine that string at the crown of the head. Mountain pose. Enjoy a little bit of stillness here. Reason my sequences aren't sticking in my head today. Ground down through the feet. Lift all your toes up off the ground. Stretch them, squinch them, place them gently back down. On your next inhale, sweep the arms wide and up overhead. Exhale, very slowly start to swan dive down with a flat back all the way back to your forward fold. Inhale, look up, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. One more time, inhale, halfway lift. Forward fold, exhale. Inhale, one more time, halfway lift. Exhale, fold and step the right foot back, coming into a low lunge. We'll drop that knee, bring the top of the foot to the mat. You can stay low and just figure out your alignment right here, feeling the sensation in the body. You can also start to come up, bringing hands onto the front knee, stacking shoulders over hips. Bringing hands to the hips, make a few micro adjustments so you can keep those hips level. And if your balance feels good today, make sure that front knee is not coming forward of the ankle. We can sweep the arms up overhead, reaching high. Exhale, drop those shoulders. On an exhale, frame the front foot with the hands. Step back to plank. holding plank for just a moment. Maybe your knees are up or maybe they're down on the ground. Just make a nice straight line from shoulders to knees wherever you're at. Holding strong. Let's come down knees. Hug elbows in at our sides and let ourselves all the way down to the ground. Inhale, baby cobra, just the head and the shoulders reaching up off the mat, reaching through the crown of the head. Exhale, float the forehead back down to the mat. Inhale, cobra. Exhale, back down. One more time, cobra. And let's hold for three breaths. Reach through the crown of the head, keep the neck long. Achoo, bless me. It's great being down on the floor and you're all the cat fur. And press yourself up through tabletop or plank. We'll come all the way back to downward dog. Still walking that dog or leaving the knees bent if you need to. Let's walk the big toes to touch at the center of the back of the mat. We're going to bring our right knee into our chest, sway forward, and float that foot between the hands. Then we'll drop that back knee and come into a lunge on the other side. Again, checking that that front knee isn't coming any further forward than the ankle. You can bring the hands onto the knee, stacking shoulders over hips. Maybe bring hands to the hips and make those adjustments with the hips so they face perfectly forward. And if your balance feels good, again, you should be on two skis, not on a tightrope. You can sweep your arms up overhead, reaching high. Exhale, relax those shoulders. Inhale, reach. And exhale, frame the front foot. Step your way up to a forward fold and let your upper body hang nice and loose. Bend your knees if you need to, shake it out. Inhale, look forward, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. And inhale, reverse swan dive with a flat back all the way up, pressing hands together and coming to heart center. Good job. Standing in steadiness. Standing in stillness. Mountain pose. Feel stability of the feet. Maybe rock slightly side to side. Feeling the balance. Maybe rock forward and back, onto the heels, onto the balls of the feet. And settle back into stillness, imagining yourself nice and tall and relaxed. Inhale, sweep the arms wide and up overhead. Exhale, swan dive down. Forward fold, inhale, look forward, halfway lift. Exhale, fold, step the right foot back, low lunge. Inhale, sweep up to the variation that makes sense for you. Exhale, fold, frame the front foot and step back to plank. Lower yourself down, knees, chest, chin, hugging elbows in. Inhale, cobra. Exhale, press yourself up and back to downward dog. You can go through tabletop or plank if you need to. We're going to stay for three breaths. You can always drop down into child's pose if that's what you need. Let's bring big toes to touch. Bring the right knee into the chest, swing forward and place that foot between the hands. Set up for low lunge on the other side and inhale to sweep up. Reaching tall, exhale, frame the front foot and step your way up to a forward fold. Inhale, look forward, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. And inhale, reverse swan dive all the way up. Hands together to heart center. Mountain pose. Enjoy stillness. Take a deep breath. Bring your awareness back to the body and the breath. Notice again if you're holding any tension in the body. One more time. Inhale, sweep arms wide and up. Exhale, swan dive down, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. This time step left foot back. Coming into a low lunge. Inhale, sweep up. Exhale, frame the foot and step back to plank. Lowering down, knees, chest, chin, or chaturanga. Inhale, cobra or up dog. Neck is long. Exhale, press yourself up. Downward dog, pressing hips up and back. Commit to three breaths of stillness here. Toes to touch and bring your left leg to your chest, swaying forward, step that foot between the hands, coming into a low lunge on the other side. Inhale to sweep up. Exhale, coming down, frame and step up to a forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift, fold, inhale. Come on up, hands together to heart center. Good. Stand in stillness. You can bring your hands down to mountain pose. Inhale, sweep the arms wide and up. Exhale, swan dive down. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Step your right foot back. We're going to stay in a high lunge this time. You might need to adjust. Make sure you're on two skis, not on a tightrope. And if you want to try to come up, start by bringing hands to the front knee. Testing out how this feels. Maybe shoulders start to stack over hips, and then you can bring hands to the hips. Bend that back knee, and then press out through the back heel. See if you can square the hips. And if your balance is feeling good, you can sweep your arms up. Reaching tall, grounding down, sink into stillness here. Breathing deeply, trust your body. Exhale, hinge forward at the hips. Nice straight line from heel all the way up. And then you can frame the front foot and step your way back to downward dog. Bending those knees, walk the dog, take a moment. Bring big toes to touch at the back of the mat. Bring right knee into the chest and swing it forward between the hands. Again, low or high lunge on this side. You can start to come up by bringing hands to the knee. Once the shoulders are over the hips, you can start to bring shoulders, hands to the hips. Word salad. Bend that back knee towards the ground, straighten out through that heel. See if you can square the hips to the front of the mat, keeping the pelvis level. And you can reach up high overhead. Inhale, reach. Exhale, let the shoulders drop. Sinking into stillness here, feeling the balance, feeling the breath. Exhale, start to reach forward until you're a nice straight line from your heels through your fingertip. And then frame that front foot, stepping back to downward dog. Take a moment to notice how that feels. And sink down into child's pose, knees wide, toes together, sink the hips back. Find a little bit of stillness, a little ease after effort. Breathing deeply. Check in with your body. Make sure you are on the same page. You can stay here in child's pose as long as you like. Sitting or laying down and breathing would give you at least some of the benefits of a moving yoga practice. If you're ready, on an inhale, come back up to tabletop and bring yourself back to downward dog, bringing big toes to touch at the back of the mat. On an inhale, raise your right heel high up and back. Keep the hips level and square. Find a little bit of stillness here. Maybe you feel this in the glutes or in the lower back. Adjust if you need to. You can come out of it. You could do a pulse where you lower and raise. One more breath. And exhale. Bring it down. Resting here or going to child's pose if you need to. When you're ready, on an inhale, we'll raise the left heel high. Straight up and back. Maybe you're doing a pulse or maybe holding and finding some stillness. Feeling the strength in that standing leg. Feeling your balance and stability. Go ahead and bring that foot slowly back down and sink down into child's pose. Sink the hips back. If you like, you can bring the hands back along the body. When you're ready, on a and inhale, float back up to tabletop. Coming back to downward dog. Let's bring big toes to touch. Bring the right knee to the chest, swaying forward. Coming into a high lunge again. Inhale to sweep up high. Again, you can bend that back knee, reach back through that back heel. And you can stay right here if this is a comfortable edge for you, if you find yourself a little bit wobbly. If you would like to try to come into Warrior Three tonight, you can walk that back foot a little forward. And very slowly with control, we're going to hinge forward at the hips, working on our balance, keeping that front knee just a little bit bent. And see if we can raise that back leg off the ground, flying into Warrior Three, testing our balance. If you need to come back, you can either put that foot down. You can practice with a table or a wall in front of you if you need support. Exhale, let's do forward fold with a standing split. And go ahead and relax that left leg down. Forward fold, relax the upper body, shake it out a little bit. Everybody come into a forward fold at the top of the mat, whether you did Warrior Three or not. Inhale, look forward, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, rise up, all the way up to standing. Hands to heart center, back to mountain pose. Enjoy that stillness and steadiness. Notice if there's a difference in the sides of the body. We're going to have to do Warrior Three or another high lunge on the other side to even out. On an inhale, sweep your arms wide and up. Exhale, swan dive down. Inhale, look forward. Exhale, fold. This time step the left leg back into a high lunge, rising up. Maybe high lunge is good enough for you. Maybe that lightning lunge where you hinge forward was a good edge. Or maybe you want to try. Did I just do this side? I did this side, didn't I? Whoops. Sorry about that. Everybody step forward. Step your right leg back instead, silly me, rising up into a high lunge with your left leg in front this time. Happens to everybody. Sinking, finding stillness, maybe trying out that lightning lunge, hinging forward at the hips. Just holding here, or if you want to try coming into Warrior Three, you can step that back foot up another inch or two. Feeling the balance on that front foot. You can start to take off, coming into a nice flat Warrior Three. Hips are level to the ground. Arms are strong, reaching forward. Spine is long. Everybody, forward fold. Come forward in a standing split. Let the head sink towards the earth. Raise that leg and then lower down. Forward fold. Shake out the head and neck. Maybe walk the fingertips to the outside of the right foot. The outside of the left foot. back to center. Inhale, look forward, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, come on up, standing in stillness, in mountain pose. Let's walk our feet wide on the mat. Toes might point out just a little bit. We want our knees to track over those toes. We want to try to keep our heels on the ground if we can. We're going to come down into a yogi squat, malasana. You might need to adjust as you go down to get the right stance so that your heels are relaxed on the ground. Maybe you can't go down quite this far. That's okay. Inhale to raise the heart. Exhale, relax the tailbone towards the earth. Press the palms together, press the elbows out. Feel the knees hugging into the elbows. Find a little bit of stillness. Two options to get out of this pose. You can either place your hands down and raise yourself back up, or if you're nice and low and you feel comfortable, you can sink back and let your tailbone roll back on the mat. And we're going to roll all the way back down until we're on our backs. Let's bring our heels close to our hips. You might be able to feel the heels if you brush them with your fingertips. Place the arms down alongside the body for support. Feel the whole back body come in contact with the mat. Breathing deeply. I won't make you do any more lunges today. Let's play just a little bit with bridge pose before we get to a final rest. Inhale, tilt the tailbone up. Maybe peel the tailbone and the sacrum up off the ground. Squeeze the thighs in towards each other, nice and strong. Go ahead and let the tailbone rest again. Inhale, tip that tailbone. Maybe raise up a little higher this time. Press into the feet. Exhale, come back down, placing each vertebra back on the mat. You can keep up with this flow, just tilting the tailbone, peeling one vertebra up at a time. You can start to press into the feet and press into the backs of the arms to raise the hips up. Make sure you're squeezing those thighs together so they're nice and parallel. If the chin and the chest start to come together, you can walk the shoulders close and clasp hands behind the back. Keep your neck where it is. Just look up at the ceiling. You don't want to look side to side in this pose. Press into those feet. Raise the hips nice and high. You can commit to a few more breaths here. When you're ready to come down, just come down slowly, one vertebra at a time. Placing them carefully back on the mat. And when you're done, you're going to walk those feet wide. Let the knees gently fall side to side like windshield wipers. Gently relaxing the lower back and the hips. Squeeze the right knee up into the chest. Extend the left leg long. And Let's let the arms fall out at shoulder height and let that knee twist and fall across the body. Keep both shoulder blades locked on the ground, glued down. You can even look towards the right fingertips while the right leg is pointing the other way to help keep that shoulder blade down. Breathe into the twist, finding some stillness. Impact. Inhale, reach long. Exhale, relax. And inhale, roll onto the back of the hips. Let's squeeze both legs into the chest for a moment. You can rock a little side to side. Bring the knees side to side, draw little circles. Then we'll keep the left leg in and extend the right leg long on the mat. Again, let's bring those arms out at shoulder height. Then we'll let the left knee fall across the body in a twist. Keep that left shoulder blade glued down. You can look towards the left fingertips if that helps. Just find a little stillness here, breathing into the twist. Thanks, Frank. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, relax. And inhale, roll onto the back of the hips. Hugging both knees into the chest one more time. Taking any other motions that feel like they might be helpful so you can relax. And then we'll come into a final rest. Maybe it's Shavasana with your legs extended long, toes pointing out. Maybe you like a bolster or a pillow under your knees. Just find some way that you can get comfy and rest for a minute or two. This is your time to absorb the effects of your practice. Feel your bones become heavy. Feel the weight of the body sink into the mat. Start to take a slightly deeper breath into your belly. Maybe inviting some gentle movement into the toes and the fingers. You can roll the ankles and the wrists. You can rock the head side to side, warming up the neck. You can bring the arms up overhead for a nice long banana stretch if that feels good to you. And when you're ready, roll over to your right side. Resting for a breath or two, feeling that heaviness and relaxation that we've cultivated in practice. Let yourself sink down into stillness one more time. Appreciating yourself for taking this time for yourself. Appreciating your body and everything it does for you on and off the mat.
When you're ready, you can press into your hands and let yourself flow up like water to a comfortable seated position. Feel your sits bones on the ground. Feel your vertebrae stack. Bring your hands to heart center. Take a nice deep inhale. Let it go through the mouth. Thank you so much for joining me this evening. I hope you can let yourself sink into stillness. Namaste. Mm-hmm.